two families compete to name the most popular responses to a survey of some simple questions. The answers are locked into our game board and every point is worth 50 rand. In round 3 and 4, the points are doubled and then tripled in round 5. The family with the most points at the end of round 5 play for a jackpot of 75,000 rand. South Africa, it's time to play Family Feud. Give it up for Steve Harvey.
Thank y'all very much. I appreciate y'all. I do. Thank y'all, man. Thank you very much, everybody. Well, welcome to Family Feud South Africa. I'm your man, Steve Harvey. All right, so listen, this is how the game works, everybody. I've had researchers going out on the streets of Mzansi. And what they've done is they've been asking you some answers to some very, very simple questions. If you can guess the proper answers that are locked into the game board, one of these teams can walk out of here with some serious money, and they're doing it all for their favorite charity. So, today, this is a very special Family Feud because this is a celebrity edition of Family Feud where I personally get to meet the cast members of two of the hottest soapies in South Africa. Yeah. Yeah, baby. Everybody, let's hear it. Give it up for the cast from Rhythm City. And they're playing against the cast from Scandal. Give me Mzamo, give me Brighton.
Oh, cool.
Ew.
I know, Steve, I know.
What did you do?
I just slipped, literally, and just fell.
Well, come on up, man. Brighton, how are you, sir?
I'm good, I'm good. When you're done with him, I mean, you know, he's trying
well,
to steal
we
the show.
Well, we were concerned, you know. I don't know what to tell you, man. Good luck.
Thank you.
You could hit this button and go that way. Come on, man, be strong now. Come on, let's go. We've got the top 7 answers on the board. All right, here we go. We asked 100 women, name something women love to touch on a man.
Head.
Brighton.
Yes, sir.
Chest.
Chest. Pass or play? Pass or play?
Play.
Play, let's go. Let's go.
Oh, back, oh, right, yes.
Brighton, so I'm here to learn. I was really excited when they told me they were gonna have a celebrity edition because I wanna meet the stars of the continent, right? So I thought it was really cool. What's your role on the show?
I play Quentin Nyati. I am a CEO. You can, I mean, come on. Quentin Nyati, just very quickly down the line, who this is his baby mama, that's his actual mama, that's a dude he's gonna get into business with one day, and that's the lady who's just everywhere. That's just...
Wait a minute. This is your baby's mama.
One of them.
What? One of the baby mamas. Yeah, you're gonna be real, boy. Yeah, all that's good until it's time for child support. This is your, one of your baby's mamas.
One of them, yes.
This is your...
Actual mom.
Actual mama.
This is one you're seeing now.
No, I'm his mother. I gave birth to him.
The mom.
I slept with
him. You're the mother?
I'm the mother.
I thought, what? I thought this was your baby's mama, and I thought this was your sugar mama. No, that's what I thought.
I mean.
That's what I thought.
I like you.
No, you look amazing.
Thank you.
To play his mother?
Yes.
You gotta be kidding me.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Oh, no, I ain't the way we doing it in the States. Uh-uh, no. Brighton, we sleeping with everybody. And you, let me come around here, girl.
I heard and I know.
Because you have the name
of the one
of
you
a
love.
Woman I love. Girl, this is Margie. Yes. This is the baddest chick in the world, y'all. So this is really good. Man, okay, all right. Let me tell you something. Can I tell you something? Truly. I really am excited, man, because I think this is so cool. This is really, really cool for me. So thank you all for giving me this pleasure.
Thank you.
What is your charity you're playing for?
We are playing for Joburg Children's Home.
Joburg Children's Home.
Yes.
All right, let's go. All right, well, let's play. We ask 100 women to name something women love to touch on a man.
His testicles.
We just got on TV here in South Africa. We would like to stay. His two little buddies. All right, Natasha, let's go. We ask 100 women to name something women love to touch on a man.
His inner thigh.
His inner thigh. My man.
Yes,
tell me your role on the show.
I play Kumani Langa, a young, highly focused businessman who's running a family business.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Lot of people out here clapping for you, man.
Yes, sir. I see.
Hey, baby. All right, man, let's go. We ask 100 women, name something women love to touch on a man.
His belly.
His belly. Yeah. They like to rub. Yeah, I'm gonna show you what I've learned. They like to rub on the blesser. His belly. they're not abs anymore. They are been covered. Your role on the show, Margie, tell me.
Sure. She's a busybody, nosy, mm-hmm. thinks she knows it all, loves money, gossips, and she's the...
Marjorie, let's go. We talked to 100 women to name something women love to touch on a man.
Her butt cheek, his butt cheeks.
His
on.
Butt cheeks. Yeah. Brighton, only one strike. We talked to 100 women. Name something women love to touch on a man.
His lips.
His lips.
What kind of woman are these?
We got two strikes. We have to be careful. Rhythm City can steal. Mapeseka.
There we go.
Name something women love to touch on a man.
His hands.
His hands. holding hands. Natasha.
Yep.
We got two strikes. We got to be careful the Rhythm City can steal.
No pressure.
Talk to 100 women and name something women love to touch on a man.
Biceps.
His biceps. His biceps. Ayanda.
Yes, sir.
My man, two strikes, we gotta be careful. Rhythm City can steal. Talk to 100 women, name something women love to touch on a man.
That they do touch our necks, man. Just like that.
Just like that.
Yes, sir.
Your neck. You have a chance to steal, Rhythm City. Talk to 100 women. Name something back. Women love to touch on a man.
Back. His back.
His back.
Yes.
Put your hands on his back. Let's look at that remaining answer, number 4. She said that. Well, this is a start, folks. We got a good one. Rhythm City not on the board. Scandal got 84. Don't go away. We'll be back. We're playing Family Feud. Yeah. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. We got a game, Rhythm City not on the board. Scandal got 84. Give me Petronella, give me Impasica. We surveyed 100 people. Top 7 answers on the board. Name something that uses up data on your phone.
Data. WhatsApp.
WhatsApp. Pass or play?
Play! Play. We play.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. Name something that uses up data on your phone.
Dang, data.
All right, man, so here we go. Tell me a little bit about the show Rhythm City. Give me an idea, because I don't know, because I'm here learning, right?
Right.
So, like, is it compared to any show in the States that I might know?
Empire?
Empire, yeah.
Empire, boom, yeah. Got it. Yeah. Got it. Sure. Now I know. All right, I got it. Rhythm City, Empire. Okay, I got it. Oh, that's cool. All right, so introduce everybody.
Okay, so here on my left, this is the lovely Petronella. She's a colleague of mine. Amazing, stunning, beautiful. We have our eye candy there. This is...
Jesse say, because he moved out the way, because I'm looking at Linda, Jesse going, me, I'm going, yeah, move, Jesse. Two different eye candies here. Go ahead.
Yes, and then we have the veteran, very talented, Linda, stunning. Yeah. And we have the equally beautiful Mr. Boho.
Yeah. All right, and what charity are you playing for?
We are playing for?
Reach for a dream.
Reach for a dream.
Reach for a dream. I like that. So Petronella, who is your character on the show?
I play Pearl on Rhythm City. She basically follows very closely in her father's footsteps. And he's a dangerous man.
So I'm assuming that would make you a dangerous woman.
Yes, oh, yeah. Sir.
This is why I'm moving on to Jesse. So tell me about your character.
I play the character Z, and his father also following in his father's footsteps. But what's interesting is that my father is her father's rival, and we're lovebirds.
Yeah.
No, Steve. Yeah.
So it's a bit of a Romeo and Juliet.
I'm coming to work early. We got to practice. All right, you ready to play? Let's go, Jesse.
Oh, yeah.
Name something that uses up data on your phone.
Instagram.
Instagram. Social media.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what Instagram is. Linda, how are you?
I'm very well, thank you. And how are you?
Good, good, good. Who's your character on the show?
I play a character by the name of Zianda Gumbi. She is a businesswoman and a sangoma.
What is that?
A sangoma is a person who is a traditional healer. And they have been called on by their ancestors to heal people. And they can see into people's futures.
That one alone, too. Yeah. All right, Linda, come on. Name something that uses up data on your phone.
I would say YouTube.
YouTube. Tobago.
Bo-ho.
Te-bo-ho. All right, cool. I'm getting it. A little slow, but I'm getting it. All right, so tell me your character on the show.
Yeah, I own a chisanyama.
You own a what?
I own a chisanyama. So it's
chicken
like a...
Chicken and sandwich store?
No, like a barbecue... Joint.
Oh, I was close.
You were close.
Chisama, chicken sandwich. Chisama, chicken sandwich. I thought I had nailed it. So a joint.
Yeah, a joint. A food joint.
Are you a warm person on the show? Really nice?
Very warm. I feel like I'm the heart of the show. Yes? Yeah.
All right, you ready to play?
Yeah.
Name something that uses up data on your phone.
Apps.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Item Zamo, name something that uses up data on your phone. You all don't have any strikes.
Email.
Patronella, only one strike. Tell me something that uses up data on your phone.
Google.
Jesse, only one strike. Tell me something that uses up data on your phone.
Netflix.
Scandal, get ready to steal. All right, come on, we need this. Name something that uses up data on your phone.
I would have to say banking apps.
Banking apps. Brighton, name something that uses up data on your phone.
Music.
Number 7. Number 3. game now. Rhythm City got 75. Scandal got 84. We got a game now, everybody. Don't go away, because after the break, our two teams are going to be playing for double points. We're playing Celebrity. Family Feud in South Africa, man. Yeah. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. We got a good game now. Rhythm City got 75. Scandal got 84. Give me Jesse. Give me Natasha. Oh, yeah, it's on and cracking. Let's do it then. We got the top six answers on the board. Points are double. Let's quit playing around. Here we go. Name a part of a chicken that South Africans love to eat.
The drumstick.
The drumstick. Everybody loves drumsticks. Everybody likes drumsticks. Okay, Jesse.
Livers. Yeah, yeah. Livers. Yeah. Livers. Yeah.
Can't buy no livers in no store. What? Livers.
You can walk into the store and buy a packet of livers.
Livers! Come on, just pass or play.
Play?
Play.
Play. Play. Let's go.
Let's do it. Let's do it.
Name a part of a chicken that South Africans love to eat.
As I throw my bones, I see chicken feet.
Yes.
Yes. Are you serious? Are you? Chicken feet? Ain't no meat on no damn chicken feet. What are you eating? What are you eating? It ain't nothing but bones and toenails. This better not be up here. This bet not. Chicken feet.
Number one.
The number one answer.
The number one
of a chicken part people eat in South Africa is skinny damn feet. That's the most unbelievable. Chicken feet. I don't, well, name a part of a chicken that South Africans love to eat.
Dikilana.
Also known as giblet something? Yeah.
Yes.
Giblet.
Yes.
Oh, giblets.
Giblets.
Okay. Giblets!
Well done, well done.
I'm scared of your answer, Mzana. I don't know what the hell you getting ready to say. Name a part of a chicken that South Africans love to eat.
Wings.
Now, drumstick wasn't up there. Please. You have to like wings.
Yes. Yes.
Wings! Yes, Petronella.
You got this.
Name a part of a chicken that South Africans love to eat.
Intamo. Necks.
Necks.
Yeah. Chicken necks.
Chicken necks.
Yes.
What?
Chicken necks.
What? Chicken necks. Feet.
It's on
necks.
There. It's on there.
There's more meat on the chicken. The neck. Man, hey, man, hey. Y'all need to cut necks. Jesse.
Yeah.
You got one strike.
Mm-hmm.
Name a part of a chicken that South Africans love to eat.
You know, I'm gonna go with chicken breasts, actually. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Chicken breasts. We got two strikes, Rhythm City. We gotta be careful. Scandals can steal. Name a part of a chicken that South Africans love to eat.
I'm gonna have to go for those juicy thighs.
Thigh.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. You got this. It's all on
you. You got two strikes, Rhythm City. You can clear the board with this one right here, or scandal can steal. Give me a chicken part that South Africans love to eat.
I'm gonna go with chicken hearts.
Hearts,
Steve.
Y'all tripping now. Y'all tripping, really? Chicken hearts?
Yeah.
Hearts. Name a part of a chicken that South Africans love to eat.
Chicken heads.
You have got to be kidding. You eat chicken heads?
Yes!
Chicken heads. That was round three. Rhythm City 75. Scandal got 248. Don't go away after the break. We're playing for double the points. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. We got a game. Rhythm City got 75. Scandal got 248. Give me Linda. Give me Ayanda.
Ayanda, just good sportsmanship.
Sangoma, no.
Yeah.
Good thinking.
You know. Yeah. Top six answers are on the board. If you could control a toddler with a remote, which button would you use the most?
The power button.
The power button. Ayanda.
The stop button.
Stop. Pass the play.
Play. Okay. All right. Okay.
Marjorie.
Yes?
If you could control a toddler with a remote, which button would you use the most?
Fast forward.
Fast forward. Brighton, if you could control a toddler with a remote, which button would you use the most?
Rewind.
Rewind.
Yes!
Oh! You're actually doing well, because this is a tough question. It really is. Mapasika.
Yes.
If you can control a toddler with a remote, which button would you use the most?
Mute. Hula! Hula, Wana!
That right there, that's my favorite button. Mute.
Yes, man! Yay!
Natasha, woo! If you could control a toddler with a remote control, which button would you use the most?
Pause.
Pause. Pause. That was a good answer. If you could control a toddler with a remote control, which button would you use the most?
Tone down this thing. Volume down. What is this
volume.
Thing?
Down. Yes, down. Sir. Turn down. Turn down the volume.
Uzama, change the channel. Change the channel. Change the
channel. You got it?
Yes.
All right, here we go. If you could control a toddler with a remote control, which button would you use the most?
Change the channel.
Yes.
Change the channel. Let's see the remaining answers. Number three.
Yay.
What's number one? All right, Rhythm City, Scandal, listen to me closely. This is important. This is the last round, and everyone up here has everything to play for. Rhythm City with 75, Scandal with 340. Now, remember, this is the last question. Point values have been tripled, so any one of you could win. Whoever, at the end of this round, has the most points, goes on to play Fast Money for a chance at winning 75,000 Rand. All right, give me to Boho and Marjorie. All right, ladies, point values are triple. This is big. Let's go. Top five answers on the board. Give me a reason why someone would ignore a phone call. Marjorie.
An ex-boyfriend.
An ex-boyfriend.
Debt collectors.
Debt collectors.
Oh, yes.
Oh. We're gonna play. Boy.
Oh, come
that,
on.
Y'all got that over here too, huh?
Yep. Oh, yeah, they're everywhere.
Oh, that'll make you not answer the phone. Mm-hmm. All right, man, let's go. Give me a reason why someone would ignore a phone call.
Because they're cheating.
Because they're cheating. Because they're cheating. Petronella.
Yeah.
Give me a reason why someone would ignore a phone call.
Because they don't want to talk to you?
Because they just don't want to talk to you.
Yeah.
I don't want to talk to you. Jesse, give me a reason why someone would ignore a phone call.
Because they're busy getting busy.
See? Now, that's a real player answer right there.
Oh,
that
man.
Ain't a regular person idea. That's a player problem. That ain't a problem most people have. But a player? Oh, yeah. I can't get that right now. I'm in the middle of something. because you're in the middle of getting busy with Jesse. Give me a reason why someone would ignore a phone call.
The only thing that comes to mind right now is telemarketers.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's really good.
That's a good one.
That's a good answer.
That's a good one. This is for the win. Telemarketers.
Okay.
Only one strike.
Okay, don't worry.
If you get this answer here, you will win the game. If not, you'll have two strikes. Give me a reason why someone would ignore a phone call.
Because of work?
Because of work.
Yes.
Because of work. We are down to one answer. We are down to one last try. We are down to the captain of the team. The leader. Give me a reason why someone would ignore a phone call.
Because it's the in-laws?
Because it's for the win, the in-laws.
Rhythm City, there are not enough points on the board for you to win. So Scandal, you win either way.
This is for all the points. You can walk away from here with a chance at winning 75,000 plus the points. On top of that, that turns into rands also. You can walk out of here with a lot of money for your charity. That's what we're playing for. Okay. Give me a reason why someone would ignore a phone call.
Unknown caller.
Unknown caller. Unknown caller. Number two. That's it, folks. All right, but here's the situation. Rhythm City, me personally, I want to thank you for allowing me to meet you today. It's been an honor. You all are truly some gifted people. Thank you so much. Didn't have all the best of luck here, but you played really well. You all played well. And for that, we add up your total, and your favorite charity are taking away 14,400 rand. KFC is gonna donate another 10,000 rand for your charity also. So you're walking away with a total 24,400 rand. Thank y'all very much. I'll talk to y'all. Hey, I need two of you to play Fast Money. Two of you. Whatever two you want. I got Brighton. I got Marjorie. Fast Money, 75,000 rand. Favorite charity right up there. Welcome back to The Feud, everybody. The Scandal family won the game. And now it's time to play. All right, here's how Fast Money works, Marjorie.
Okay.
Brighton is off stage. He can't see or hear your answers.
Okay.
I'm gonna ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. Try to give me the most popular answers. If you can't think of something, just say pass. I'll get back to it if we have enough time. Then if you and Brighton together come over 200 points, tell everybody what you'll win for your favorite charity.
75,000 rand.
75,000 rand. Wonderfully charming there, Marjorie. Let's make it happen.
Okay.
Ready?
Ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name something you would buy that suddenly brings you new friends.
Car.
A word that starts with under.
Underwear.
The worst job at a hospital.
A nurse.
Something you can lick.
Ice cream.
A letter of the alphabet that isn't often used.
X.
Come on, let's say it. Hi, Margie, darling. Name something you would buy that suddenly brings you new friends. You said a car. Survey said? Name a word that starts with under. You said underwear. Survey said? The worst job at a hospital. You said what everybody needs, a nurse. Survey said? Something you can lick. You said ice cream. Survey said? A letter of the alphabet that isn't often used. You said X. Survey said? Brighton?
Yes, sir.
All right, Brighton, she got 176. You need 24 points to win. I'm gonna ask you the same 5 questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. I'm gonna say try again. You give me another answer. It's gonna be a little bit tougher this time, so we can give you 25 seconds. You ready?
I am ready,
all right,
sir.
Let's remind everyone of Marjorie's answers. Those wonderful answers there. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Here we go. Name something you would buy that suddenly brings you new friends.
A car.
Try again.
A phone.
A word that starts with under.
Undertaker.
The worst job at a hospital.
Dying.
Something you can lick.
Ice cream.
Try again.
Lollipop.
A letter of the alphabet that isn't often used.
X.
Try again.
Y.
All right, let's go. Let's turn it on. All right, Brighton, we need 24 points for 75,000 rand.
I mean,
let's get it over with. Name something you would buy that suddenly brings you new friends. You said a phone. Survey said car. Car was the number one answer. We're 16 points away from 75,000.
I mean,
a word that starts with under. You said undertaker. Survey said. Underwear. Underwear was the number one answer. Did I tell you that car was the number one answer? Okay. We still need 16 points. The worst job at a hospital. You said, damn. That's what he said? Okay, we're still gonna be needing some points here. Boy, you're making this way more suspenseful than it's gotta be. We need 16 points and we're gonna still need 16. Cleaner. Cleaner is the number one answer. We need 16 points, I say. Something you can lick. You said lollipop. We need 16 people to say this, man. Survey said. Ice cream was number one. X was number one. Well, Scandal, that's 75,000 rand, but they're walking out of here with a grand total of 92,000 rand. Great job, man. All for their favorite charity. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time, folks. Good job, man. Hope you had a nice time.
Well, thanks so much. Thank you.
Good night.